Good morning. This is Kanupriya Sachdev, and it's morning in India now. And I'm going to present my oral presentation on synthesis and characterization of few-layer pristine and nitrogen-doped CVD graphene for supercapacitor application in this International Conference on Advances in Functional Materials 2021. So this is the outline of my presentation. So basically, I'll be talking about the experimental work which we have done and the results which we have received from this experimental work and certain conclusions. So graphene is already a well-established material for the supercapacitor application, given its large area and extraordinary functional properties. And doping a heteroatom in this graphene is a very effective way of enhancing the electrochemical performance of graphene. So this is the idea we have taken. And normally people have done, the researchers have used ammonia as the source for doping in graphene. But considering the hazardous nature of ammonia, we have used nitrogen replacing the ammonia in this work. Okay, so this is the diagram which gives you the device fabrication which we have done, and the two anodes are the CVD grown graphene, the pristine, as well as the nitrogen doped. And then we have the this is a sodium ion capacitor device where we have NaClO4 PVA hydrogel membrane as the electrolyte as well as the separator. So this is the method which we have used to grow the graphene, the pristine and the doped. So in case of, as I said, in case of the ammonia is used as the source of carbon in the graphene, and the argon gas and the hydrogen gas, they are used for annealing the copper substrate for 180 degree before the growth phase at a rate of 100 and 50 SCCM per minute respectively. We have taken polished and HCl treated copper substrate as a catalyst in the process. The methane gas was used as the carbon source along with the hydrogen gas at the rate of 25 and 50 SCCM respectively. The growth of graphene was allowed for 35 minutes, maintaining the chamber pressure at 150 torr and the temperature at 950 degrees centigrade. The samples were allowed to cool down to the room temperature inside the furnace. So this is the process for the few layer growth by the graphene, and the optimization of the processing conditions gives us the control over the number of layers which we get in the pristine graphene. And for the doping for this graphene, we had introduced the nitrogen gas as well. Once these pristine and the doped graphene layers were grown, they were transferred to the desired substrate, and this was the usual transfer process using the PMMA. We had done the transfer of these few layer graphene on the desired substrate. So after getting the sample, we used the characterization techniques to verify the about these samples and to get the information about them. So this slide shows you, it gives you the field emission scanning electron microscope images of the CVD grown graphene on the copper substrate. And this one gives you the nitrogen doped graphene on the copper substrate. At the lower side, the EDS spectra of the pristine graphene and the EDS spectra of the nitrogen doped graphene sample are given. And we can very clearly see the presence of nitrogen there. The peak shows here gives you the presence of the nitrogen there. So the EDS spectra confirms the growth of the desired samples. These are the high resolution transmission electron microscope images of the CVD grown graphene sample. And the inset gives you the SAID pattern, and the SAID pattern is quite, giving you the hexagonal pattern which gives the crystalline nature of the grown graphene. Then we also checked that what is the number of layers which we got in the sample, as we wanted only a few layers there. And these are the Raman and the UV visible spectra for these samples. The peaks, the characteristic peaks of the graphene, which are the D band, G band and the 2D band, when we found the, when we saw calculated the ratio of the ID and IG and the ratio of I2D and IG, then we could see that the number of layers in case of the pristine graphene was up to 5 layers, up to 5, and for the nitrogen doped graphene it was 3 layers. And then this is just the UV visible spectra of these two graphenes. Checking the thermal stability of these samples, we found that the nitrogen doped graphene, which is shown by the red curve, it is a more thermally stable sample, so naturally a better characteristic for the electrochemical applications. Doing some Hall measurements on these samples, we found that the nitrogen doped graphene had a better conductivity, and the mobility also was increased. We can see it's almost 3 times the mobility in case of the pristine graphene. And this leads to a very good conductivity, increase in conductivity of this graphene. So the nitrogen doping has been found usually by the researchers to increase the conductivity of the samples, and we found the same. So these are the, now checking the electrochemical performance of these samples, these are the results of the cyclic voltammetry, and these are the cyclic voltammetry plot of the CVD grown pristine graphene showing the specific capacitance, and these are at different scan rates from 10 millivolt to 200 millivolt per second. Okay, so there's a typo here, this should be millivolt per second. And then we could, when we checked the cyclic voltammetry of the nitrogen doped graphene, then we could see that, you can see very clearly that there is an increase in the area of the plot, and moreover the shape of the curve is giving moving towards a square shape, and it's not exactly the ideal EDLC behavior. It has some curve at the top, so that means there is some pseudo capacitance also showing in these samples. So the doping actually results in some pseudo capacitive behavior, and the combination of the two, EDLC and super capacitive behavior, may increase in the result of the electrochemical performance. So these are the galvanostatic charge discharge curves of the two samples. The upper one shows for the pristine graphene and the lower one for the nitrogen doped graphene. Again, better electrochemical performance was seen by the nitrogen doped graphene in terms of the power density as well as energy density, the calculated ones. This gives you the electrochemical impedance spectroscopy, EIS behavior of the two samples, and the EIS spectra, the red one is for the nitrogen doped graphene. This plot, you can see it's quite steep as compared to the pristine one. And what we found was, when we calculated the series resistance, we saw a drop in the resistance in case of the nitrogen doped graphene. So we can conclude that the number of layers which we got from the Raman spectroscopy, we could see that it's a few layer graphene sample. The high resolution TEM images show the transparency, very good transparency in these samples. The EDS spectra gives you the confirmation of the nitrogen doping there, although the amount is quite small. There were no impurities detected in the synthesized sample. The Hall measurements give the superior conductivity caused by doping, and quasi-rectangular shapes in the cyclic voltammetry indicate the introducing of the non-Faraday capacitance in the device accompanied by the pseudo-capacitive region. The galvanostatic charge discharge gives an enhanced energy density and power density in the nitrogen doped graphene, and the nitrogen doping in the graphene results in a higher aerial capacitance due to the enhancement in electrochemical activity in comparison to pristine graphene. Thank you.